First of all, highly gifted in mathematics and interested in physics. He was gifted in mathematics and interested in physics. And after finishing school, he decided to study at university in Zurich. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So he was gifted mathematician and was interested in
physics.
Yes. Because it can also be seen that unless you know the mathematics, you cannot understand physics. Okay? Mathematics is the instrument to understand the science. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So what he did, he decided to study at university in Zurich. Okay? But the science was not the only thing that appealed to the dashing young man with walrus mustache. Means he was a very handsome guy, a dashing young man with walrus mustache. And the science, it was not only the science which was which he liked most, but the other things also he liked. Let's see what the other thing is. He also felt a special interest in a fellow student, Mileva Merrick. He also have a special interest, keep quiet. Einstein also have a special interest in one of the fellow student who was, the name of that friend was?
Mileva
Merrick.
He found to be clever. He found that she is a clever. Okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, he finds she is a clever. This young sir, this young sir had come to Switzerland. She has come to Switzerland. Why? Because the university in Zurich was one of the... Yes. Because the university in Zurich was one of the few in Europe where women could get degrees, okay?
Yes, sir.
So that particular university, it was only one where women could get degrees. So that is why she is here at the University of Zurich. Because this is the university where women could get the degrees. Other universities was not allowing women to give them degree, okay?
Yes, sir.
So that's why she was there. Einstein saw in her an ally against the Philistines, those people in the family and at the university to be constantly false. Okay? So he looks that particular girl with ally, means as a friend. Okay? As a friend. Against the Philistines. Against the Philistines means the people who do not like literature and art. Means he do not like the people who do not like literature and art. And she was also like that. She was also liking that literature and arts. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So she was not like Philistines. Okay?
Yes, sir.
And he also do not like Philistine people. He likes the people who like this music, literature and this. Okay?
Yes, sir.
But the Philistines people were not liking that. The couple fell in love. Okay? The couple fell in love, later survived, in which they put their affection into words, mixing science with their tenderness. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So they fell in love and they exchanged the letters. In that exchange of letters, what they used to do? They write their emotion with the science. They mix the science because they both were the science students. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So mixing their feeling with science. They use the term science to share their feeling. Letters survive, in which they put their affection into words, mixing science tenderness. Einstein wrote, how happy and proud I shall be when we both have brought to our work on a relativity. Why are you talking? Okay. Einstein wrote, how happy and proud I shall be when we both have brought to our work on relativity to a victorious conclusion. So he is saying that if we would come together,
yes,
okay, if we would come together,
yes,
we can write better theory on theory of relativity and we can come to the conclusion. So he says like that.
Yes, sir.
To that girl. What is the name of girl? Meliba?
Mary.
So next see what happened. In 1900, at the age of 21. In 1900, at the age of 21. He was at the age of 21 and still was at the age of 21. Because Albert Einstein was a university graduate. Now he is a university graduate. At this age, he was a university graduate and unemployed. Another thing that he was unemployed. So, remember this thing at 1900 he was at the age of 21. 1900 he was at the age of 21 and he was university graduate and at the same time he was unemployed. Okay? He worked as a teaching assistant.
Yes, sir.
Gave private lessons and finally secured a job in 1902. Okay?
Yes, sir.
At 1902, he secured a job. Okay? Yes, sir. He secured a job. He secured a job. Okay. But during these two years, what he did? He gave private lessons. He worked as a teaching assistant. He worked as a teaching assistant. He was a teacher.
Yes, sir.
During these 2 years, he was a
teacher.
Teacher.
Yes, sir.
He gave private lessons and finally secured a job in 1902 as a technical expert in the patent office in Bonn. Okay? Remember this. Technical expert. Don't talk. Technical expert in the patent office. In patent office. What is patent office? Anybody knows what is patent office in Berlin? Okay? Yes, what is patent office? And what the term patent is? Yes, stand up.
A document which gives the right to invention and invention.
Okay. Shut up. It is a document.
Yes, sir.
Whenever you invent something.
Yes, sir.
Okay?
Yes,
then whenever you invent something, you write the patent that I have invented this, and after that no one would be able to say that no, he has not invented, I have invented. So it is a patent letter, okay?
Yes, sir.
So he was working as a technical expert in patent office at Berlin, okay? Then what is Berlin? Capital of Germany.
Yes, sir.
By mistakes I have wrote that one because in this topic Germany is always used. Means in World War II, there was a lot of discussion about Germany. So this, at this period also it was a World War II period is also. Because 1900 to not. When was World War II happened?
1945.
Yes. And first World War? 1945. And second 1939 to 1945. So, yes. It is also discussed in this text also. Okay. That's why by mistake I written Berlin. Okay. While he was supposed to be assessing other people's invention, while he was supposed to be assisting other people's invention, Einstein was actually developing his own ideas in secret. Okay? So at front he was assessing, means he was giving ideas to other inventors, but at the secret what he was doing? He was doing his private inventions. Okay? actually developing his own ideas in secret. No, he was developing his own ideas in secret. He is said to have jokingly called the test drawer at the work of neurophysical physics. So the office in which he worked, there he got a drawer. In that drawer, what he used to kept the secret files, secret things, and he used to call it Bureau of Theoretical Physics. He said,
yes, sir.
The desk he named, in which he was sitting, the Bureau of Theoretical Physics, okay? He has given that name to that drawer, okay? One of the famous papers of 1905 was special theory of relativity. What was that? Special theory of relativity. It was very important one. I should write it at the top. Measured in itself, not in relation with anything else. So they are measuring itself, not having relation with another one.
Yes,
okay?
Yes, sir.
As you know the relation between time and distance?
Yes, sir.
You know it,
sir? Yes, sir.
Speed per hour, distance upon
time.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
In the same way, indeed, two perfectly accurate clocks will not continue to show the same time if they come together again after journey. One of them had been making very fast rate for them. So further he's saying, in fact, if we have two different watch, okay?
Yes, sir.
And having same time, okay?
Yes,
two different watch having same time. But when we go to the take one watch to into journey, and when we come again back, then there is some difference between their timing.
Yes, sir.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
Some difference will be there.
Yes,
so that is why he said these two countries are not absolute. Okay?
Yes, sir.
From this followed the world's most famous formula which describes the relation between mass and energy.
Yes, sir.
The relation between mass and energy is
mc square.
What is E? Energy stands for energy. M stands for
mass.
S stands for
speed
of light. Means he is saying, when any object, let's go to the world of physics for some time. So what he's saying, that's when any mass, okay, any mass when accelerated or given very much speed, so it got very much energy, okay? C square, multiplied by C square. If means M multiplied by C square. Like if this is a shock, okay? If I will throw this chalk to someone with this speed, but he will not get injury. But if I will increase the speed, the energy will be increased. Okay? Energy will be increased. So it's directly proportional to speed. Energy is directly proportional to the square of the speed of light. Okay? From this follow the world famous formula which describes the relation between the mass and energy. Okay? Tenth paragraph. While Einstein was solving the most difficult problem in physics, now he was solving the most difficult
problem
in physics. His private life was unremitting. And his private life was not so good. Okay? His private life was not so good. Albert had wanted to marry Milva Wright. Okay, she was wanted to marry that girl. But what is the problem? After finishing his studies, but his mother was not agree, okay? Her mother was
not agree.
Her mother was against it. She thought of Milva, who was 3 years older than her son. Mileva was 3 years older than Einstein. Okay?
Yes, sir.
That girl was 3 years older than
Einstein.
That's why her mother was against the marriage of
Mileva and
Einstein. Okay?
Yes, sir.
You stand up. So where I was? He wanted to marry that Mileva. Her mother was against
Mileva.
Against it. She thought Mileva was 3 years older than her son and was too old for him. She was thinking that she is too old for Einstein, okay?
Yes, sir.
She was also bothered by the Mileva's intelligence. She was also bothered by the Mileva's intelligence. She is a book like you. She is thinking that she is also book like you. Do, you two are bookworm, okay?
Yes, sir.
Bookworm.
Yes, sir.
So his mother said Einstein put the wedding off, and that's why Einstein put the wedding off. Okay?
Yes,
so he did not marry to Mileva.
Mileva.
But the pair finally married in January 1903. But finally they got married.
Yes, sir.
Somehow they married and they got married. After so many so many time, not after so many distance. Her mother was not agree, but then also they married after some time, okay? And they had two sons. How many sons they have?
Two sons.
Two sons. But a few years later, the marriage faltered. What is faltered? Become weak. Their bond become
weak.
Yes, sir.
Mileva, meanwhile, was losing her intellectual efficiency and becoming an unhappy housewife. She was not happy because now she was becoming a housewife and she was also a good intellectual. She was a scientist.
Yes, sir.
And she has to live in confined lifestyle like a housewife. So she wanted to do something in life. That's why she was not happy and their marriage faltered. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Mileva meanwhile was losing intellectual ambition and becoming an unhappy housewife. After 3 years of constant fighting, the couple finally divorced. So in 1919, couple divorced. Okay?
Yes, sir.
They divorced after 3 years of fighting. Einstein married his cousin Elsa the same year. So what he did? He married his cousin Elsa, okay?
Yes, sir.
Elsa. Elsa.
He married,
she was a cousin,
yes, sir.
In the same year. Okay,
yes, sir.
Let's see.
Yes, sir.
Einstein's new personal chapter coincided with his rise to the world fame. Now this new chapter coincided.
Yes, sir.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
Coincided with his rise to world fame. What is coincide?
Yes, sir.
Yes, you want to explain something? What is the meaning of coincide? What do you understand about this? Yes. In Hindi we can say ittefaq. Einstein's new personal chapter coincided with his rise to world fame. Means at one place he was getting fame.
Yes, sir.
And his, and there was a new chapter also. He got married to new girl, that is
Elsa.
Elsa. Okay?
Elsa.
So these two were happening at the same time.
Yes, sir.
He was getting fame and married to new girl Elsa.
Elsa.
In 1915, he had published his general theory of relativity.
Yes, sir.
1915, he published the general theory of
relativity,
which provided a new interpretation of gravity. Okay, which provide a new interpretation of gravity. Means which makes you more understand about gravity. So theory of relativity makes you understand. Makes you more clear about
gravity.
Everybody knows about gravity?
Yes, sir.
What is gravity?
Yes, sir.
Yes, you? Stand up, what is gravity? Explain it. Don't.
Sir, just
speak in English. Then it's called gravity. And the earth gravity means earth attracting to other bodies. Okay? And the formula already you know. I have directly proposed to M1, M2 and R1. Okay? G M1, M2 upon R. minutes come back in English. So where I was? He had published his general theory of relativity, which provided new interpretation. You have to remember this thing, new interpretation to. Through the sun's gravitational field. So what he have calculated correctly?
The sun's
light.
Which light?
Liquid.
Star.
Suppose this is stars.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So light from these stars would be deflected through sun's gravitational field. How they will get deflected from? Sun's gravitational field. Okay. What is the meaning of deflection?
Change
the direction. Okay.
Yeah.
It is not like the reflection, refraction. There are three terms are used there. You must have studied at physics. Reflection, refraction, and this word is deflection. Okay. We are talking about deflection. What is deflection? Yes. Whenever any light falls at any surface, okay, light falls, it changes the direction, changing the direction. Okay? But it is not like reflection, because in reflection what we see, an angle of incident is the angle of reflection. Means the incident line makes equal angle with reflection. And at refraction also what we see, when light goes from denser to rare medium, it reflects from its path. It's away from. So that is deflection. Have you understood deflection?
Yes, sir.
Changing the path but not making same angle at the case of reflection. Okay?
Yes, sir.
This is deflection.
Yes, sir.
So the newspaper proclaimed his work as a scientific revolution. The newspaper proclaimed means what? Announced that this work was a scientific revolution. So this work was a scientific
revolution.
Yes? Scientific revolution. Einstein received the Nobel Prize for Physics in 1921. What for that?
1921.
Nobel Prize.
Nobel Prize.
Yes, for physics. He was showered with honors and invitations from all over the world and lauded by the press. So he was praised. What is the meaning of lauded? What is the meaning of lauded? Praised.
Yes,
Nazis can put build and use their attack, and he was afraid.